opportunity for me to step back and take a look at my experience and share some of my experience with you guys. Before I start, let me tell you a little bit about my education and my background before I started med school. So when I graduated from high school, I wanted to continue my career in science, so I applied to the science program at Miami College. At that time, I was interested in molecular biology, so I joined. When I graduated from CGEP, I went to microbiology and biology program at the university. At the time, I wanted to pursue my career in research and education. However, when I was doing my undergrad degree, I found myself to really enjoy the classes that were more tailored towards the medical field and clinical science, such as physiology, anatomy, pathology, and pharmacology. So it kind of sparked my interest in medicine, and I wanted to learn more, so I decided to go to the medical field and join several volunteering programs at the Jewish General Hospital and the Royal Victoria Hospitals. However, the experience that really pushed me towards medicine was the one that I got by volunteering at EMS, which stands for Emergency Medical Services of Foot Soccer City. I don't know if any of you guys know what it is. It's an organization. It's quite small. Basically, it's a first responder organization that gives services to patients who call 911 before their arrival on the So with that organization, I was able to be actually directly involved in patient care. And the experience showed me that the satisfaction that I got from it was really great. And it showed me that I like medicine not only the theoretical part of it, but also the practical part of it. So it kind of confirmed my interest in medicine at that point in time. When I was also part of EMS, I got a little bit of exposure to organizational management because it's a volunteer-run and volunteer-based organization. It still had several departments which were run by the members, so the whole running of the organization was done by the volunteers. Me in particular, I was part of the clinical department. I was in charge of data gathering and statistical analysis, but I also got a chance to interact with members who were involved with education, equipment, logistics, and so on. So I kind of got a first-hand experience on what it's like to run a non-profit organization with very limited financial resources and a really large membership base. So my experience with EMS basically proved to me that I want to go into medicine, but at the same time, it made me realize that no matter where I'm going to end up as a physician, the quality of the services that I'm going to provide to my patients will not be influenced only by my clinical competence, but also by the surrounding and the environment where I'm working. And a lot of the decisions made by the management and the authorities at the top will translate itself into the services that I give to my patients. So with that in mind, I started to apply to medical schools. And when I was going through different universities and different programs, I discovered that my field was offering something very unique. To me, I was really surprised to know that McGill actually recognized that the need for clinician managers in healthcare and was offering the program of a MBA, which is a combination of a management degree and a medical degree at the same time. And as I have to admit that the more I advanced in my studies as a medical student, the more I rotated to different hospitals, different provinces, different cities, the more I realized how important it is for any healthcare provider to really understand the healthcare system, the economic, political, social factors that shape our health system, and also to understand the material science, because we ultimately are going to be involved in some aspect or the other of running the places where we work at. And it's also, as I go to different hospitals, I see a lot of physicians in the administration, be it running the department, be it running the clinics, because they realize that whatever decisions they are managing will ultimately affect the care that they give to patients. Our medical education is very saturated with the clinical science, and obviously it's understandable. We finish our medical school, we have to continue our training as a residency, we have to specialize and do a fellowship. There's simply not enough time to prepare physicians for anything else. There's not enough time to prepare physicians to work in healthcare, to teach them the healthcare, the economics, the politics involved, to teach them administration. And just to give you an idea, in the 4 years of my medical school, we are given 3.5 weeks of public health dealing with epidemiology, disease outbreaks, disease prevention, screening, community health. So 3.5 weeks, it's really not enough to teach everything there is areas of topics of public health and a lot of physicians are going to be in very close proximity to public health issues in the future. We also give them a 3-hour lecture. In 4 years of medical career, a 3-hour lecture on the Canadian healthcare system. Again, as a physician, I'm going to be an integral part of the system. I'm going to influence it and it's going to influence my career. So 3 hours is really not enough to learn everything there is to know about the history, the factors that shape up our healthcare system. And also, the healthcare system of Canada should not be studied in isolation. Obviously, we need to learn what else is going on in the world. We've given 0 hours of teaching on healthcare business administration. And again, as I mentioned before, a lot of physicians do opt out to take on this dual role of clinician and administrators in the future. So they basically learn in the field once they go out there. So there are a lot of gaps that the medical education has that I felt were actually a need degree bridge for me. And at the same time, having a business degree obviously opens up a new career opportunity. So not only you can work as an administrator in the hospitals, if you choose to have a medical practice, you have skills to do that. If you want to be an entrepreneur and open up pharmaceutical kinds of companies, you have more skills to do that with a business degree. Just to give you a little bit of an idea of the presence of the program, the dual degree in DME is very popular in the United States, and the reasons were quite obvious. But, you know, the healthcare of the United States is much more prioritized, and the physicians act more as a businessman in the United States. So more than 50 universities in the United States offer a DME program, including Harvard, Tufts, Columbia, Yale, Georgetown. In Canada, this program is fairly new and not as popular, so there's only two universities. McGill was the first one to start this program, and then Calgary University joined them. The University of Ottawa offers Master's in Health Administration. It is not a dual degree. It's a 15-month program that focuses on health administration only. And McGill and DME opened its doors in September of 1996, and the first class graduated in 2001. As you can see, there were 5 graduates at that time. The classes are still very small. It's a small purposeful program. Just a little bit about the curriculum. So MD degree usually is 4 years. With MD/MBA, you have 5 years in total. When I joined the program, the MBA part was composed of 60 credits, and that was the MBA on its own was 60 credits to begin with. So the first year you spend doing only MBA. And then in the summer after my first year, I did an internship project and I did an MBA Japan program, which I'm going to explain a little bit in details later on. And I did an elective, so in total it was